So now that he gave him a little breakdown of what these people are and what they did and how they turned around and how when they weren't following God's laws, they were destroyed and led captivity. But when they did, they prospered. Now he gave them a little tidbit about who they were. Read.
If there be any error in this people,
if they're sinning against their God, read.
And they sin against their God, let us consider that this shall be their ruin.
So now, if we see that they're sinning against their God, let's go overtake them. Let's go over there. We can overtake them because they're sinning against God. God's not going to fight for them.
They weren't thinking like that.
That's what they're saying. That's what I'm telling you. That's what he just said. Read that again. Verse 20.
Verse 20. Now therefore, my Lord and governor.
So remember, he was like, my Lord, let me tell you something about these people. If they sin against their God, we can overtake them. Read.
If there be any error in this people.
Uh-huh.
And they sin against their God.
So if those people are sinning against their God, we
let us consider that this shall be their ruin.
We can ruin them. We can overtake them. Read.
And let us go up, and we shall overcome them.
See? Read.
But,
listen to this. But
if there be no iniquity in their nation, let my Lord now pass by.
But if they do what God said, we better pass by them. Because they're not a people to reckon with.
Right.
When they keeping God's laws, we better not try to overthrow them. Why? Read.
Lest their Lord defend them.
Lest God gonna be on their side.
So we are weak.
That's right.
So we are weak.
We are weak without God.
That's right.
You know what I'm trying
right.
to tell you.
Right.
We are nobody without God. If we're not keeping God's laws, statutes, and commandments, we're going to stay right here in the bottom of society.
Right.
That's what I'm trying to show you. All through the Bible, it says that, my brother. So that's what we have to do. Read.
Lest their Lord defend them and their God before them.
Uh-huh.
And we become a reproach before all the world.
And we're going to get destroyed before all the world if we try to go against them when their God is defending them.
Right.
That's what he's saying. So what we have to do? 1 Corinthians 11. So we know all through the, when you read it from the beginning of the Bible to the end of the Bible.
I did it. I don't understand it.
That's why I told you these brothers right here in the purple and gold. We came and we start building ourselves up in the scriptures. Our leadership have shown us that. And so what we do is now we've been reading because our people don't like to read. And we know that we came out here with pictures and the understanding of the scriptures to show our people that this Bible is our history book.
That's right.
This Bible is not a fairy tale. This
right.
is true.
Yeah.
It has happened. This is written documents that have happened.
That's right.
Read that.
Psalms chapter 111, verse 10.
Bring it out.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
So when we start fearing God.
I do.
When we start fearing God and doing his laws, because that's how you show you fear God. Because, for example, your son, you say you had a son, right? Now, if you go tell your son, hey, go clean your room, and he don't clean his room, does he fear you?
No.
He don't?
No.
But when you put that hand to that behind, we're going to say, I'm going to go clean my room because I fear that that hand going to come to my behind.
Right.
So we didn't fear God. That's why we go against his commandments.
Right. Right.
And guess what? That hand to the behind is this right here. See, slavery will happen. And exactly what was going on today, we hate each other. We're the only nation that are like that. That's because we've been destroyed. God let this happen to us because we were disobedient. That
right.
was that hand to the behind.
That's
you see what
right.
I'm saying? It's going to continue to happen till we turn our ways around.
Right.
Read that.
It might be too late.
It's not. It's not. That's why we're here to tell you. Read.
A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
You're going to understand this Bible. If you're doing his commandments, you're going to understand it because he's going to make sure you understand it. Jump to 1 Corinthians. Now, this is a start. So you know who God's chosen people are. You know why they're in the condition that we're in today. Because why?
Disobedient.
Let's see how we start to be obedient. Read.
1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3.
Bring it out!
But I will have you know.
Read.
That the head of every man is Christ.
So the head of every man, every Israelite man is Christ. The person above Israelite man is Christ. Read.
And the head of the woman is the man.
The head of the woman is the man.
They don't see it.
They don't see that because we've been destroyed, but this is the order that God put up. Read.
And the head of Christ is God.
So that's a divine order right there. That is the order. God, Christ, man, woman, then children.
Right.
Right? So you, ultimately, if someone is above you, you always give respect to that person, right? Check this out.
They don't do
read.
It today, though.
Every man,
read.
Every man praying or prophesying,
uh-huh.
having his head covered,
read.
Dishonored his head.
So, every man, remember the man, Christ is over the man, God is over the Christ, man is over woman. Every man playing or in the midst of prophecy, like what's going on right now, we showing all the prophecies. We bring them to light to the people. You are in the midst of prophecy. So every man, read again.
Every man praying or prophesying,
uh-huh.
having his head covered,
uh-huh.
dishonoreth his head.
So if you are in the midst of prophecy or praying and you have your head covered, you dishonor the person who's above you. You understand what's going on? So what does that mean?
Well, I guess you're not acknowledging the person that's over you.
Not right. So you're not showing respect to the person that's over you. So read it one more time slowly.
1 Corinthians.
First, I'm going to ask you, who's above man?
God. Jesus.
Jesus, right? He is above us, so we're supposed to show respect to him, right? Let me show you something. Read.
Every man praying or prophesying.
Uh-huh. Just like we're doing now. Read.
Having his head covered.
Having his head what?
Covered.
What covers your head?
My hair.
Your hair?
Yeah.
What about that cap that's on it?
Yeah.
The cap, right? That's what's covering your hair, right? Read.
Dishonoreth his head.
So if you in the midst of prophecy or talking about scriptures and you have a covering over your head, you do what?
Dishonoreth his head.
Who's the head of man?
I'm not gonna wear a cap.
Read it one more time.
Every man praying or prophesying.
When you are praying or when you are prophesying, which is what we all doing right now, talking about the scriptures is prophesying.
Right.
When you're doing those things, what are you supposed to do?
Having his head covered,
uh-huh.
dishonoreth his head.
So your head should never be covered when you're talking about scriptures.
Right.
Why the Pope don't do it?
Because you know why? Because they deceive them. They're not reading this Bible for what it is. They pick and choose what things they want to do. But what happens when we pick and choose and do what we want to do?
That's disobedient.
It's disobedient. So what we need to do is do exactly what the scriptures say.
Right.
So when the scriptures say, as an Israelite man, when we talking about God or when we praying and we have a hat on, it's disobedient against God.
Right.
So now that you know that, what should happen?
I should take his hat off.
My brother.
But I love this team.
But you could put it back on once we're done.
But that's a curse too.
What's a curse?
Jesus, like I love this team.
That's what I'm trying to explain to you.
That's a curse.
So do you?
I recognize what I'm doing is wrong.
Right.
Because a lot of times when my team is coming on, I won't go to church. I ain't going.
Okay.
I put my team before God.
Okay. That's so what about right now?
Well, you breaking it down for me.
So now I'm explaining to you that. It's a simple thing just to take your hat off to show reverence to Christ and God in this moment. All praises the Most High. So you know what you just did right now? That is called repentance.
Right.
The churches teach you that repentance is just to say, I accept Lord as my God, my Christ as my Lord and Savior, and I believe in him, and that's it. That's what they call repentance. However, or they call repentance when you get dipped in water and you get pulled out. But what happens? You get dipped in water, you can be a murderer, killer, steal, you can be a sodomite,
rapist,
all those things.
Yeah.
When you get dipped in water, when you come out, all you come out is that same thing except for now you're wet. But repentance is when you change.
Right.
When you're doing one thing that's against God's laws, now you turn around and say, no, I'm going to do what God said. That's called repentance. So when God said, when you in the midst of prophecy or you praying or talking about God and reading the Bible, your head has to be covered. If you're a man that and you uncover it, that's called repentance. Because at one point you didn't know that. Now we're showing you that. You see what I'm saying? Let me show you another thing. Give me Leviticus 21. There's a lot of laws in this Bible, about 613 or so. However, we look, I see you made that face like, damn, that's a lot of laws,
yeah,
right?
Of law. Yeah,
you drive?
Yeah.
You drive, right?
Yeah.
All right, so check this out. You know how many traffic laws are there?
A bunch of them.
It's over 1,400 laws, right? Is that more than 600?
Yeah.
That's over double, right?
Yeah.
So, do you get pulled over every second of the day?
No.
You don't, right?
No.
Because you're obeying the traffic laws. You see how easy it is to obey those laws? You see how easy it was to take your hat off? Easy. God's laws are not grievous. They're very easy to do.
Right.
These brothers in purple and gold are keeping God's law.
There's so much temptation
right.
in the world.
It is, but you must overcome the temptation. He is trying you. What he's doing is saying, okay, I see he's keeping my law. Let me see if he's true and for real. Let me tempt him with this. Now, when you overcome it, you are purging out your old man. Read that.
Leviticus chapter 21, verse 5.
This is another law. Read.
They shall not make baldness upon their head.
You ever see Michael Jordan?
Yeah.
Bald is that, right?
Yeah.
Charles Barkley.
Yeah.
All them brothers, right?
I need to do it, but I'm not going to do that.
Read.
I'm going bald. I'm going to keep my hair as long as it stay up.
All right, read.
Neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard.
What's that mean?
Not to shave?
Not to shave your beard. That's a law. That's God's law. You see how these brothers got beards?
I see all y'all. Yeah.
I'm going to show you something about this beard. Where's the Zonovan?
Well,
going
back to Samson that he, with
Jadala, Delilah. No. That's not what it's talking about. What it's talking about, give me a beard in that. So God said that his chosen men, the children of Israel, his chosen, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and natives, we're not supposed to shave our heads bald or shave our beard. There was a reason for that, because this was right when we came out of Egypt. All right? Read that.
Beard. Oh, this is the Zondervan Compact Bible Dictionary.
Uh-huh.
Definition of beard.
Read.
Beard, a badge of manly dignity.
A what?
A badge of manly dignity.
So, you know, like when a police officer comes up, he has that badge. That gives him authority,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So what does God say that gives us authority? Read.
A badge of manly dignity.
Keeping God's laws, having that beard, that's how you show yourself a man.
That's right.
Right.
Because you have a beard.
Right.
We got the concept of shaving. We got the concept of shaving during slavery. That's when we got the concept of shaving. When they would say, hey, boy, come here, boy. Why would they call you boy? Because you look like a boy with a shaven face.
Right.
It's a sign of disrespect. You see what I mean? So to have, keep reading that.
The Israelites were forbidden to shave off the corner of their beards.
God, listen, this isn't a book written by God. This is a Bible dictionary written by probably a so-called white man who understands the Bible and that God's chosen people are not supposed to shave their beards.
Right.
So the other nations understand that, however, we don't. That's what we out here trying to show y'all. That the beard is a badge of manly dignity.
Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.